Hello from the Arlo Lab. My name is Anna and I am your virtual technical assistant. Today we will be going over the Arlo Doorbell device settings. In this guide, we'll walk through everything you need to know about accessing and customizing your device settings right from the Arlo app. Before getting started, make sure your Arlo Doorbell is installed and connected. Check out our installation videos for more information. Let's get started. Once the device is installed, tap on Devices. Find your doorbell in the list and tap the gear icon in the top right corner to access the device settings. At the top, tap on the device name to open device info. From this page, you can rename your doorbell by tapping Edit, typing a new name, and hitting Save. Next, you can see the product type, which tells you the model of your device. Next, you can toggle the indicator LED on or off. This light shows when your doorbell is fully charged. Please note this is only available on the Generation 2 doorbells. In device info, you can also check the location your device is assigned to in the app and change it if needed. You can also check the firmware version and update if a new version is available. Here you can also view the hardware details, like the model number and serial number. And finally, you can see the regulatory information or choose to restart or remove your device at the bottom of the page. Back on the main device settings screen, you'll see more options to tailor your doorbell's behavior, such as viewing the exact battery percentage or which Wi-Fi the doorbell is connected to. Tap on it to change network or check the connection to find the ideal location with a strong connection. Next up, optimizing your doorbell for how you use it. We'll start with power management. Here you can choose between best video, optimized, which is a balance of video quality, and battery life or best battery life. There's also low power mode, a great feature of the Arlo Generation 2 doorbells that snaps a still image instead of recording a full video when the battery gets low. You can set the threshold here as well. Next, we have video settings. Here you can adjust the video resolution or enable or disable high dynamic range. You can also adjust the brightness of your video. And lastly, you can change the flicker adjustment. The next setting we can change is night vision. Here you can toggle the setting on and off. Below that, we have audio settings. Here you can enable or disable the microphone as well as the speaker and adjust the speaker volume. Next, we can fine-tune what your doorbell sees and reacts to. In zones, you can create, edit, or delete activity zones and privacy zones. Check out our video about battery life for more information. In default mode settings, you can adjust the motion sensitivity. You can also adjust the recording length and at the bottom change siren volume and duration. Next, we have a few settings that are available only for the doorbell. When someone presses the doorbell button, you will get a call on your phone and we can customize the settings to best fit your needs. First, we have silent mode. When we enable it, any incoming calls and chimes connected to the doorbell will be silenced. However, we can toggle the incoming call option to only have calls or the chime option to have only a chime ring. Toggle both on to not get notifications when someone presses the doorbell button, but still have the chime ring and get a call. Next, we have button LED, which we can toggle on or off for when motion is detected or when someone presses the button. Under call settings, we have the toggles for using the phone speaker and microphone when a call is answered. This is an important setting to check if for any reason you or a visitor cannot hear the other. You can also toggle the voicemail option so that the visitor can leave a message if you are unable to answer the call. Next, we have chime settings. Here, if the doorbell is connected to a traditional chime, you can change the type of it. If it's connected to an Arlo chime, you can change the melody and volume. Lastly, we have the language where you can change the language of quick reply messages. If you ever need help, scroll down and select Product Tour to view a doorbell introduction or tap on the Support section for quick access to the Arlo support site or Arlo community. And at the very bottom, we have the Paired Device section where you can pair Arlo chimes to your doorbell if you have one installed or install a chime to pair it. And that's it. Your Arlo doorbell is now set up and customized to fit your needs. If you ever want to explore more features, the Arlo app is packed with powerful options to keep you in control. Thanks for joining me here in the Arlo Lab. See you next time.